they took away
our boosted
nitro. They
don't want
to hear the rules. You should stop.
They're like, oh, you shouldn't have
to. Oh, it's definitely.
I already did that. It's not. Please stand up.
Just like, let's change it. Wait, where do we have free?
Alright, let's go.
Like, we're a little too loud.
Thank you.
audience, please rise as we welcome your 2023 City High Middle School graduates.
Thank you.
Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors by the Union High School JROTC and the singing of the national anthem performed by the City High Middle School Jewel Tones. Please be seated. Joining me on stage this evening are Mrs. Kimberly Williams, Board of Education President, Ms. Jen Schottke, Board of Education Treasurer, Ms. Kimberly Davis, Board of Education Trustee, Jose Rodriguez, Board of Education Trustee, Ms. Ari Wade, Board of Education Trustee, Mr. Jordan Eatman, Board of Education Trustee, Dr. Ledrian Roby, Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Brandy Lovelady Mitchell, Deputy and Superintendent, and Mr. Matthew Beresford, Executive Director. I would also like to acknowledge several of the GRPS cabinet members who are seated in the audience. Please rise. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Ledrian Roby, Superintendent of Schools. Following Dr. Roby, we welcome Mr. Matthew Beresford, Executive Director, to the podium.
Good evening to our 2023 graduates. I will not be very long, just a couple of phrases and trinkets as you begin this next phase of life. Always remember to act with courage, even when you don't feel like it. Keep the company of people that you admire. You will become more like them. Never wait for the perfect circumstance. Begin with where you are, with whatever you have. Let curiosity and enthusiasm always guide you. Happiness is not a permanent state, but wholeness is. Don't ever confuse the two. Practice your passions. Keep your brain full of ideas and your heart filled with optimism. Continue to make your community proud of your walk. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2023.
Good evening. As proud executive director of City High Middle, I'm going to be a warm demander for just a few minutes of this beautiful ceremony this evening. Seniors, please continue to be the owner and author of your unique story. It is your divine right to own your positionality as you write this next chapter, which starts tonight. I challenge you to avoid the errors of living in the land of entitlement and refuse to take more than you give to your local community, family, and friends. Muhammad Ali once said, "Service to others is the rent you pay for your room here on earth." Never forget the unique talents and skills you already possess that can be used to help others, to help preserve the environment and protect the most vulnerable. There will be moments when you encounter others that may seem automatically adversarial, and I challenge you to remain calm and attempt to build bridges between your differences. Remember that we are most effective in our professional and our personal relationships when we develop the skill to really listen to one another. And it's our unique differences that make us a stronger society. Lastly, as you write your goals in this next chapter, be bold and unafraid of failure. Life's challenges will provide lessons of wisdom to use on your journey. And this is how you will grow wiser and stronger and more resilient. Seniors, I'm so proud of you and excited to experience the Grand Rapids, Michigan, and the world that you redesign and lead. Thank you.
Good evening. I would like to begin by thanking Superintendent Roby, Deputy Superintendent Lovelady Mitchell, and our Board of Education, district representatives, friends, family, and staff for being here. These graduates would not be here today if it were not for the support from all of you throughout their time at City High Middle School. Most importantly, I want to thank our graduates. Your hard work has paid off, and today is a day to celebrate all that you've done to get here. The journey may not have always been an easy one. There were difficult classes, difficult days, weeks, and maybe even years, but you persevered. As you celebrate this day, remember all the people who have stood by your side through your successes and failures, and make sure to thank them. They are celebrating today too. Today you have made it, not to your destination, but to a new beginning. Throughout this new chapter, don't just dream big, but create a reality, one that makes you happy. Each of you will have your own unique opportunities. Remember to be open to new things, different experiences, and to truly finding out who you are. The future holds many challenges and successes for all of you. But if your time at City has shown me anything, it's that each of you has the ability to overcome the obstacles that try and slow you down. Class of 2023, you will forever hold a special place in my heart. In just a few moments, you will each receive a diploma that marks your graduation from high school. This diploma represents your experiences in school, both good and bad, but more than that, ones that you have conquered. As you leave today, diploma in hand, my final words of advice to each of you are, set your sights high and know that with hard work and determination, you can do anything you set your mind to. Congratulations, City Class of 2023. You've made it. At this time, we hope you will enjoy a vocal performance of Bridge Over Troubled Water by the City High Jewel Tones. This version of Bridge Over Troubled Water was arranged by Kirby Shaw. The soloists this evening are Tiago Huner, Miguel Hernandez Ramirez, Jubilee Lacey Gardner, Nora Rumry, and Elise Van Artsen.
Troubled water, I will let
I would now like to recognize our class valedictorians and salutatorians. This year we have 19 valedictorians along with 4 salutatorians. I would first like to ask our salutatorians to rise and be recognized. Junie Chen, Carson Downer, Cecilia Nguyen, Nora Rumry. Please be seated. Our valedictorians equally share an honor, and I will now call them in alphabetical order and ask that each one rise to be recognized. Rohit Agarwal, Vanessa Bont, Lily Broberg, Megan Carpenter, Aaron Chen, Ashray Chabra, Ariana Esquivel Landero, Elizabeth Gannon, Mohammed Ghani, Jose Gomez Maldonado, Grayson Magley, Vishnu Mano, Robin Meyer, Evan Miller, Jane Moore, Chichien Cheong, Ethan Shi, Muhammad Sadiq, Elise Van Artsen, Sophia Shu. Please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce Mr. Vishnu Mano and Miss Elise Van Artsen and welcome them to the stage.
Good evening, everyone. Parents, teachers, staff, class of 2023, and to the 6 people I paid to cheer for me. Thank you, guys. You might remember me as the evil robot who took over the school on PNN, or the student who uses math homework as an excuse to procrastinate literally everything else. But tonight, I'm thrilled to have the opportunity of being your graduation speaker. When I started my first draft of this speech, I had trouble deciding how to begin, confused by so many experiences to talk about, so many stories to recount, and so many people to thank. In consequence, a few days before I would have to be up on this stage, I approached the superhero of City High, who can solve any problem he faces, Mr. Martinez. At first, Martinez wanted me to talk about the history of tacos with green sauce. But after reminding him that this speech was for our graduation, he gave me the incredible advice of starting at the beginning. So here goes. I joined City in 10th grade, 2020. I'll be honest, I don't remember much from that year, but what I do remember is my morning routine. Waking up 5 minutes before the start of class, opening my computer, logging onto Zoom, and falling right back to sleep. I'm just kidding. During my first year at City, the class of 2023 was just a bunch of squares on my screen. I'd never met any of you, never talked to any of you, never gone to school with any of you. Your personalities were compressed into your tiny Zoom profile pictures. Over the past 2 years, I've come to realize that the people who sat behind these profile pictures have been some of the kindest, funniest, smartest, most empathetic people in our community. as we push through IAs this spring together, crush the juniors in virtually every sport imaginable together, and positively impacted the community we grew up in together, the only feeling I was left with was gratitude. From welcoming me with open arms during my first year to supporting me throughout the academic rigor of City, I cannot thank you enough for the uniquely inclusive community that you have built. As Pericles once said, your legacy is not what is engraved in stone monuments, but what is entwined into the lives of others. Now, I have no idea who Pericles is, but I'm sure he would be proud of the legacy that our class of 2023 has achieved. From sports to journalism, debate to theater, the accolades and accomplishments that our class has achieved is truly remarkable. But none of these successes would be possible without the continuous effort of the administration at City High. Our principal, Ms. Vandervliet, regularly responds to emails at 6 in the morning and 11 at night. Despite the haze of grogginess that surrounds me as I stumble up the stairs to our school after a late night of finishing homework, I know that Sergeant Vincent will be waiting at the door with a smile, greeting each and every one of us by name every morning. The same is true with our staff. Ms. Vasidens' numerical explorations inspired me to pursue a math major in college, and Mr. Harris's commitment to our speech and debate program gave me the confidence to grow as a communicator. In fact, Mr. Harris actually drove us to a tournament in the middle of a blizzard. If that doesn't show dedication, I don't know what does. From perseverance to integrity, the lessons and values that our staff instilled in the class of 2023 has set the foundation for the leaders we will all grow up to be. For the excellence of our administration, the lessons of our devoted teachers, and the continuous support of our staff, we thank you. After all of our Spark Notes cramming sessions, all of our IA all-nighters, and all of our paper ones and paper twos, we are at the final minutes of our high school careers. I originally wanted to conclude my speech by saying congrats, saying we made it. But I know that this is just the beginning of what our class of 2023 is going to accomplish. So I'll leave you with this. In the pursuit of our goals and dreams, we often hear tales of overnight success or fortunate circumstances that seem to catapult individuals to great heights. While luck can undeniably play a role in certain instances, it is important to acknowledge the underlying truth that success is not solely determined by chance. Behind every remarkable achievement lies a story of tireless effort, sacrifice, and unwavering determination. It is through these qualities that we lay the groundwork for favorable opportunities to manifest. The late nights spent on homework, the countless hours of studying, and the unyielding commitment to personal growth that we are all too familiar with are what prepare us for the serendipitous encounters and prosperous moments that shape our lives. In other words, hard work puts you where good luck can find you. So keep working hard, class of 2023, and thank you for your time.
After all of the IAs, visits to CHIMSIB, CAS hours and projects, IOs, ERQs, SAQs, DP, MYP, I really could go on with all of the acronyms. I can guarantee that I can read almost every single one of your minds. We're done. Finally. Standing here, I can't help but think back to all of those long nights staring at my computer screen, trying to finish my EE, definitely not 4 hours before the deadline. Practice paper ones in math where I thought to myself, surely you can't do this without a calculator, right? Failing miserably at literary term jeopardy. I'm sorry, Ms. Van de Gavel, I still don't know what synecdoche means. I wish I could have told myself then that those memories of stressing over a grade or over a test aren't what I will end up holding close to my heart forever. It said over and over that life is a journey, not a destination. But I can promise you, despite it being quite cliche, that no truer words have ever been said. For For me, it's moments like saving a penalty shot at the seniors versus junior game, dissecting a squid in biology, eating Miss Ralston's chili at Walden Day, and making posters in Van Gogh's class. Above all, I want to thank you all for one thing, for not giving up when times got hard. Together, despite the exams and the papers, we've created such a wonderful community. I know I'm speaking for all of you when I say that we could not have done this alone. I personally want to thank my parents and my family who have taught me strength and perseverance. I want to thank my friends who I can genuinely say have made me a better person. I'd like to thank Ms. Muzio and Mr. Warren for showing me that biology is actually the best subject and have helped me find my passion for science. I'd like to thank all of the educators who have shaped me for teaching me how to be a good person first and a good student second. What I've truly learned, aside from all of the psychology theories and mathematical equations, is that tying your worth to a grade or even a title will not be what gets you to the finish line. What gets you there is leaning on the people around you and remembering that it is okay to live in the moment, to stop and smell the roses. We all have different journeys, opportunities, and paths ahead of us, but I hope that every day we remember the people who have helped us along the way, choose gratitude, find happiness in the little things, and maybe try and learn how to spell baccalaureate too. Thank you for your time.
I would now like to welcome class of 2023 co-presidents, Nariah Nesby and Jubilee Lacey Gardner, to the stage for the introduction of our keynote speaker.
Hello and good evening. You guys look amazing today, and I'm so happy to be here with you. And truthfully, I'm so happy that I've been able to be your president for the journey in our high school careers, and I'm just so proud of every person that you guys have become and the journey that you've been on your own. And it brings me great pleasure to introduce Sergeant Molly Vincent. This is going to be our guest speaker today, and she's a current team member of the Grand Rapids Public Schools Safety and Security Department for the last 13 years and counting. Her educational background is a bachelor's degree in criminal justice from Grand Valley State University and a master's degree in organizational leadership from Ashford University. Sergeant Vincent is married and has two children, a 7-year-old son and a 9-year-old daughter with special needs. In addition to her current security sergeant role, she's also a team safety instructor and field training officer. Sergeant Vincent has earned many awards and recognitions, including the prestigious 2013 Grand Rapids Public Schools Officer of the Year. Please join us in welcoming Sergeant Molly Vincent to the stage.
Good evening, scholars, staff, and families of City High Middle School. Thank you for the welcoming introduction. It is my honor and pleasure to be chosen by the class of 2023 to speak at graduation this evening as an important figure during their time at City. All the graduates sitting here today have worked incredibly hard at becoming scholars that are educated, self-directed, and productive members of society within the Grand Rapids Public Schools mission. Specifically, in my leadership role as security sergeant, I seek every day to establish appropriate staff and student relationships while being fair, firm, consistent, and leading by example. In a world full of uncertainty, I work hard to do my part and attempt to pass on a world with braver and bolder leaders to all our children. At City each morning, I am the first staff member you see at the student entrance, welcoming everyone by saying good morning to you personally and individually calling you by name. Remembering names is a valuable way to be connected, and it makes all of us feel important and respected when someone remembers our name. A friendly smile and good morning can make the difference in a day, even if it is too early in the morning for you. Many of you have told me that my good morning is your favorite part of the day, and it's mine too. According to your senior video, I'm also the last staff member you see as you navigate the horrors of the city parking lot at dismissal. Rather than a horror, I like to think of it as a puzzle, which is also a relatable metaphor for life. The only way to complete a puzzle is one piece at a time. Every piece of the puzzle represents an action we take, a decision we make, an experience we have, and the relationship we are in. Not only is your life about adding pieces to your puzzle, but you are also a piece of the puzzle in others' lives. Life is the most difficult puzzle you'll ever have to complete. Be patient, because just like a puzzle, it takes time for all the pieces of your life to come together. Brené Brown is an American professor, lecturer, author, podcast host, and one of my personal favorites when it comes to leadership. In her book titled Dare to Lead, she writes that leadership is not about titles, status, and wielding power. A leader is anyone who takes responsibility for recognizing the potential in people and ideas and has the courage to develop that potential. In my life, I've been blessed with several great leaders who took their time and interest to see the potential in me, even when I didn't always see it within myself. All of you have the potential inside of you to become anything that you desire to be. Just be courageous enough to go after it. Dream big, work hard, make mistakes, and be kind. My challenge and call to action for you now is to show up, be present, accept others without judgment, and welcome everything exactly how it comes. Thank you all for being pieces of my puzzle and allowing me, Sergeant Vincent, to be pieces of your puzzle. My hugs, thoughts, and prayers are with each one of you as you leave city and venture out on your new journey in the world. Reflect on the past, celebrate the present, and focus on the future. The world needs your talent, ideas, and passion. Congratulations to City High's class of 2023.
Thank you, Sergeant Vincent. Now I would like to invite our graduates to the stage for the individual presentation of their diploma. Announcing the names of the graduates this evening are City High Middle faculty members, Mrs. Erin Burke, Mrs. Erin Emperor, and Mr. Joe Weirda. The senior class and the City High Middle School community request your cooperation in refraining from loud, disruptive noises during the presentation. We want every graduate to have his or her special moment and would appreciate it if you would limit your applause to each row as the graduates return to their seats. Will the City High Middle School graduates in the first row please stand?
Yoel Bellatiste Abraham. Gozer Acopa, Colorado. Larissa Barbara Joan Adams. Rohit Agarwal. Delfino Alfaro Mora. Daniela Alonso. Victor Manuel Anselmo. Benna Christian Anderson. Saul Antonio Barradas Lima. Marcos Valentino Barrera. Dulce Madeline Barrios Perez. Vigo Charmaine Beach. Vanessa Corinne Bont. Daniela Botella Calderon. Benjamin John Brinks. Liliana Catherine Broberg. Julius Dimitri Brown. Ronnie O'Neill Burton. Gabriel Scott Buscard. Matthew Mario Como Pablo.
It's okay.
Megan Rose Yee Carpenter. Dalise Ayana Cartman. Vivian Honey Casoletto. Aaron Lindsay Case. Leonardo Marie Castillo. Daniel Cervantes. Calvin Lewis Chaplow. Sarai Daphne Chavez Torres. Aaron Chen. Junyi Chen. Ashray Chabra. Diana Romena Cifuentes Diaz. Mariah Linnell Cooper Wood. Levante Dwayne Crump. Alfredo Cruz. Inaya Elay Cummings. Quinton Michael Poirier Dixon. Itza Paula Dominguez Oliveira. Carson Robert Downer. Carter Matthew Emery. Jack Edward Emperor.
Ariana Esquivel Lendero. Elizabeth Grace Gannon. Tenaris Garcia Lopez. Mohammed Usman Ghani. Lily Joyce Glegg. Jose Angel Gomez Maldonado. Diego Gonzalez Ortiz. Erica Natalie Govea Garcia. Eleanor Francis Grimm. Maisie Catherine Hartness. Amy Jacqueline Hernandez. Miguel Angel Hernandez Ramirez. Lyric Monet Hills. Trenton James Horde. Ariana Ophelia Howell. Tiago Kenneth Huner. Musa Jafari Jama. Eli Thomas Julian. Dylan Joseph James Kemp. Emma Grace Kuiper. Jubilee Rose Lacey Gardner. Devon Lafernier. Audrey Rose Lott. Leslie Yatsiri Luna Hymus. Grayson Sawyer Magley. Vishnu Darshan Mano. Deanna Maroquin. Angel Martinez. Bree Elizabeth Mathis. Spencer Harold Corndyke McClure. Tyler Merlington. Robin Antonia Meyer. Evan Wrigley Miller. Jane Wilhelmina Moore. Samantha Morales Urbina. Magdalena Ruby Moreno. Harrison Nee. Naraya Deneen Nesby. Cecilia Tao Nguyen.
Annie Reese Norman. Lloyd Henry Nygaard Tapp. Itzel Denaye Ordunya Reyes. Brianna Jade Parm. Luna Pava. Jamie Nicole Penn. Georgia Margaret Penny. James Yaniel Perez Moran. Jamil Hassan Pimpleton. Grace Elaine Powers. Ava Christine Reedy. Jackson Connor Reimers Malupke. Sarah Margaret Robinette. Annalise Marie Rodriguez. Natalie Rodriguez Valdivia. Laura Catherine Roop. Gloria Danae Ruiz Briceño. Nora Jane Chalarumri. Anthony David Sanabria Perez. Maria de Los Angeles Sanchez Salas. Shakira Maddie Seawood. Marisabel Gloria Juanita G. Setless. Gabriel Quinton Thomas Shepherd. Tianqiang Shi. Muhammad Abubakar Sadiq.
Katia Marie Siverly. Amaria Gabri Smith. Kira Starkusik Smith. Adriana Jane Stack. Gabriella Faye Stillerman Flores. Anna Gray Sumners. Ricardo Valdez Carmona Jr. Elise Minier Van Artsen. Ian Thomas Van Acker. Casey Cooper Van Vuren. Samuel James Walcheski. Daphne Sandra Weber. Josiah Dustin White. Silas Adagio Williams. Sophia Olivia Shu. Sophie Yang.
Ms. Kimberly Williams, will you please join me at the podium? Tonight, I present to you the class of 2023 as candidates for graduation. As the principal of City High Middle School, I certify that all candidates who will be receiving diplomas have met or exceeded all the requirements as set forth by the Grand Rapids Public Schools Board of Education and the State of Michigan.
On behalf of the Board of Education, faculty, and staff of Grand Rapids Public Schools, it is my honor to accept the graduating class of 2023 of City High Middle School. And with the power vested in the board by the State of Michigan, I hereby confer diplomas on each. Congratulations.
Will the members of the class of 2023 please rise and face the audience? Members of the class of 2023, join me in moving your tassels from right to left. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present City High School's graduating class of 2023. Congratulations. We ask that the audience please remain seated until the graduates and stage guests have left the field. Will our honored stage guests please rise for our recessional?
Wait till you're announced, We've not yet lost all our graces. The hounds will stay in chains. Look upon your greatness as you'll send the call out, 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 send between teeth. Now bring my boys in. They're skinning craters like the moon. The moon we love like a brother while he glows through the room. Dancing around the lies we tell. Dancing around big eyes as well. Even the comatose, they don't dance and tell. We live in cities you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how to run. To throw my hands up in the air, so there. I'm kinda older than I was when I rebelled without a care, so there. We live in cities you'll never see on screen. Not very pretty, but we sure know how to run things. Living in ruins of a palace within my dreams, and you know we're on each other's team. We're on each other's team, and you know we're on each other's team. We're on each other's team, and you know, and you know, and you know. Wait till you're announced. We've not yet lost all our graces. The hounds will stay in chains. Look upon your greatness as you'll send the call out, 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 send the call out.